In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and brothers in Christ, we come together to offer this sacrifice this morning, to thank the Lord for all His mercy is to each one of us. In a very special way, we offer to Him our world today as it is today, especially those persons who are suffering because of their difficulties, because of the COVID that is spread all over the world. We pray during this Mass for all those who are suffering in various other ways. And as a preparation to celebrate this Eucharist, we call to mind our sins and imperfections and ask the Lord for pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant us, Lord, we pray, that being rightly conformed to the Paschal mysteries, what we celebrate in joy may protect and save us from perpetual power. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, it seemed good to the apostles and the elders, with the whole church, to choose men from among them and send them to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas. They sent Judas, called Barsabbas, and Silas, leading men among the brothers, with the following letter. The brothers, both the apostles and the elders, to the brothers who are of the Gentiles, in Antioch and Syria and Sicilia, greetings. Since we have heard that some persons have gone out from us and troubled you with words, unsettling your minds, although we gave them no instructions, it has seemed good to us, having come to one accord, to choose men and send them to you with our beloved Barnabas and Paul, men who have risked their lives for the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We have therefore sent Judas and Silas, who themselves will tell you the same things by word of mouth. For it has seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us to lay on you no greater burden than these requirements, that you abstain from what has been sacrificed to idols, and from blood, and from what has been strangled, and from sexual immorality. If you keep yourselves from these, you will do well. Farewell. So when they were sent off, they went down to Antioch, and having gathered the congregation together, they delivered the letter. And when they had read it, they rejoiced because of its encouragement. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Your response: I will praise you, Lord, among the peoples.
I will praise you, Lord, among the peoples.
My heart is ready, O God, my heart is ready. I will sing your praise. Awake, my soul, awake, lyre and harp, I will awake the dawn.
I will praise you, Lord, among the peoples.
I will praise you, Lord, among the peoples, among the nations, sing psalms to you. For your mercy reaches to the heavens, and your truth to the skies. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens. May your glory shine all the earth.
I will praise you, Lord, among the peoples.
Gospel acclamation. I have called you friends, says the Lord, for all that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you.
Alleluia. 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 Praise the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that anyone lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. No longer do I call you servants, for the servant does not know what his master is doing. But I call you friends, for all that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you, that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should abide, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. These things I command you, so that you will love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear sisters and brothers in Christ, one of the most beautiful passages we have from the Gospel according to John we just heard. Jesus tells his disciples, Love one another as I have loved you. He goes on to say, I have chosen you. Not that you chose me. I have chosen you, he says, to bear fruit and fruit in abundance. My dear sisters and brothers in Christ, wonderful to hear such powerful words from our Master and Lord Jesus. We are chosen. The greatest gift that God can give us is to belong to Him. And that we are selected to belong to Him. We are called to live in joy. You know, it is said that a sad Christian is a dangerous Christian. Christians cannot be sad, cannot be unhappy. They have to be joyful. So our choice makes us joyful, makes us happy. He has chosen us to love. And the quality of that love that Jesus says is to love one another, to love others the way He has loved us, to the extent of giving our own life, to the extent of diminishing ourselves so that others may have life. We have wonderful examples of these in the world in which we live, where Christians die in order to give life to others. And very especially during these days, we experience a lot of people, not only Christians, but people of goodwill from all over the world, literally dying every day in order that others may have life. Jesus tells us we are chosen to be friends. We are chosen to be witnesses. Witnesses of His love. You know, we know well that when there are friends, they share everything among themselves. So to say, there is no secret between them. Jesus says, I have called you friends because all that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. There is no secret of the kingdom of God that is not revealed to us. That is the greatness of our call. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, each one of us is called to reflect the life of Jesus in our life, in our values, in our attitudes, in our relationships, in all that we do. We are called to be like Jesus. Our great call is that, to belong to Him and to reflect Him wherever we are. During these troubled times, my dear brothers and sisters, let us reflect this love of God that we abundantly receive through Jesus. We abundantly receive from Jesus. Let us reflect it to others, especially to those who are in need. And may God bless you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Thanks to your goodness, this bread we offer, fruit of the earth, work of our hands. It will become the bread of life. Blessed be God. Blessed be God, blessed be God forever. God. Blessed be God. Blessed be God forever. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Thanks to your goodness, this wine we offer, fruit of the earth, work of our hands, it will become the cup of joy.
Blessed be God, blessed be God, blessed be God forever. Blessed be God, blessed be God, blessed be God forever. Amen.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by your Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity and cleanse me. Let us pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable and pleasing to God, our loving Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with the Francis, our Pope, Oswald, gracious, our Archbishop, and all his assistants, and all the bishops and clergy and religious everywhere. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her blessed spouse, with your blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Let's pray with confidence to the Father in the words Jesus, our Savior, gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace and the joy of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other some sign of peace. Peace be to you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Act of Spiritual Communion. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith and unbounded trust, perfect humility and abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion. Amen.
The crucified is risen from the dead and has redeemed us. Alleluia. Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace and joy of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, give thanks to the risen Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, give praise to his name. Jesus is Lord of all the earth. He is the King of creation. Hallelujah, hallelujah, give thanks to the risen Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, give praise to